Hey, I'm Paul Begay, AST Systems Designer. We're going to go over, once again, the endurance filter, and we're going to talk about the pumped configuration. All right, standard water pump pulling from the pond or tank, pushing through, water's coming in here and out here. Very important on your plumbing to have a ball valve and a check valve, or a one-way swing check valve, so that if you ever shut your pump off, you won't have water and beads wanting to run backwards inside of your pump, okay? So just like last time, we dyed this water with a red food coloring for illustrative purposes. All right, so let's come around here and look at the external anatomy of the filter once again. And we're gonna run through a couple of backwashes and we'll look at the sludge that's generated in this sludge chamber, all right? So, just a quick review. External sludge chamber, airflow meter. Loosey-goosey, more air in, righty-tighty, less air in, all right? Pressure gauge, normal working pressure with that 1/8 horsepower pump is about 2 PSI, all right? Somewhere around 2 to 3 is what you can expect. This area right here is your charge chamber. All right, this is where air is gonna be added. So what I'm gonna do, just for to illustrate how this works, I'm gonna bypass the airflow meter, and I'm gonna add air directly off of our compressor, all right? So let's see if we can get this right. So I'm adding air. You can see the bubble forming. It's going to come into this external trigger. Once it gets to this elbow, it's going to want to escape. And then when it escapes, it's going to shake up the beads. All right? Now, we call these filters PolyGeysers or drop filters because when that air escapes, the water and beads drop. The air shakes the beads, and the waste that's shaken off of the beads is sent all the way over, up and around, and eventually lands in the sludge chamber right here. Okay, so let's watch that happen. I'm gonna add a little bit more air. Just about to fire. Beads are shaking, waste was sent, and look at our sludge chamber right here. There's more sludge that was just generated during that backwash, all right? So, the pump wasn't shut off during the backwash. Pump is still running right now. We're filling back up. So we're just now sending water back inside. This process, when you're running through your airflow meter with an air pump, is happening as often as you'd like it to, and it's a hands-off process. I just did that so that we could see it on cue, all right? So, next week's video is gonna be an air-lifted, gravity-fed configuration of this filter right here. So stay tuned, thanks for watching.